Welcome. If you're just joining us, thanks so much for joining. My name is Barri, and this is a yoga for all class. It's time for you to practice and get on your mat today and enjoy moving and moving with your breath. So we'll begin in a comfortable seated position. Just close your eyes. Just settling in on our mats today. Rest your hands down to any comfortable seated position on your legs, in your lap. You're welcome to close your eyes and just shift your gaze down towards the tip of your nose. Letting go of any distractions, any thoughts. And we come in to the present moment, honoring this space on our mats today. Start to tune into your breath. Noticing every inhale and every exhale without judging it. Simply observing how we feel today, how our breath feels. Maybe it feels cold, maybe it feels warm. Maybe the breath is deep, maybe the breath is shallow. Just becoming a mindful observer of our breath and our body and our mind. Just stay here for a few more moments. Calming our minds, preparing for our yoga practice. With this more calm and peaceful state of mind, we can gently bring our hands together, the center of our heart. And take a moment to set an intention today. Any reason that brings you to your mat today, perhaps for inner healing, perhaps to just enjoy. Make it personal for you and try to remember it throughout the practice. And take another full deep breath in here through your nose. And as you exhale, gently open your eyes. Release your hands down by your sides. Let's start in a child's pose today. So come onto all fours. I like to take my child's pose with wide knees to open my hips, but you can take your legs wide or you can keep your knees together. And just gently shift your hips back to your heels and stretch your arms out long in front of you. In this pose, we're just coming back into ourselves, bringing our awareness back to our breath. Just settling in, quieting our minds. Our bodies might start talking to us. So we just observe and meet our body where it is today. Stay here for one more breath. And your next inhale, press into your hands. Just lift your head a little bit. And start to walk your hands over to the right. Place your left hand on top. And lower your head down between your arms. Doesn't matter how low you are to the ground. Just start to feel a nice stretch across your left side of your body, from your shoulder down to your hip. One more breath here. And on your next inhale, start to walk your hands back through the center. Then over to the left. As you exhale, placing the right hand down on top of the left, lowering your head down, just opening up through the right side body. Feeling a deep stretch from your shoulder down to your hip. Nice and easy, right? No need to push. Stay for one more full deep breath. Inhale to walk your hands back up through center. And press yourself up to all four. Tabletop position, spread your fingers wide. We'll start with some cat-cows. Inhale to arch your back, look up to the ceiling. Exhale, round your spine, tuck your tailbone. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round. You can take this movement at your own pace, moving with your own breath at your own timing, inhaling as you arch, and exhaling as you curve. If you want to build a little bit more strength in your shoulders, try to keep the shoulders right over your wrists. Especially as you exhale and round your spine, keeping your shoulders over your wrists, really tucking your tailbone. We'll just take one more here. Inhale to come back through center. As you exhale, start to bend side to side. Looking over your shoulder, back towards your toes. Again, moving at your own pace. Just opening up again through your side body. Waking it up. Or maybe it's the end of your day and you want to stretch it out. Take one more on each side. Start to circle through your whole body, sending hips to your heels, and circling all the way around. Breathing into your circle. Moving as you breathe. You can close your eyes. Don't worry about what it looks like. Take one more full circle here. Reverse your direction. Circle the other way. Good. Just let it feel good. Maybe you feel a little tightness as you move around your circle. So we're tight and hold it there for a few more breaths before moving on. One more circle here. Good. Come back for your tabletop position. And tuck your toes under. Float your knees and exhale back to an easy downward dog. So you can keep your knees bent. Just pedal out through your heels. Easing into our first, probably, downward dog of the day. And shake out your head, yes and no. Starting to awaken through your hamstrings, your shoulders. Breathing as you pedal out your feet. And take one more on each side. And find a place of stillness, reaching both heels somewhere towards the floor. If they don't touch, it's okay. You can keep your knees soft. Just try to find stillness in your body so we can find stillness in our mind. On your next inhale, step your right foot forward. Lower your back knee down and untuck your toes. Just come to a low lunge. Sending your hips forward and down. You can keep your chest connected to your thigh for a moment. Yeah, it might take a few steps to get there into the lunge. That's all right. If you have blocks, you might like to take the blocks underneath your hands also. That could be a nice variation. You're welcome to stay here, just settling in and releasing your hips. Or we can start to find a little balance, walking your hands up to your front thigh. Maybe you can take your hands to prayer. Good, and then maybe you want to come all the way up, tuck your back toes under, float your knee, and reach your arms to the ceiling, spreading your fingers wide, maybe looking up to your hands, starting to engage through your pelvic floor, your inner thighs. Just take one more breath wherever you are. And as we exhale, slowly with control, lower your hands and knee. Beautiful, untuck your toes. Shift your hips back and come to a half split. Flex your right foot. So you're always welcome to use your blocks here. Maybe slide your hands further back and take your hands to blocks to help you out in this pose. If you're feeling really open, you can walk your hands out towards your foot or even further out from your foot. Maybe take your hand around to the ball of your foot. Reach your toes back to your nose. Good. And exhale, come back to your low lunge. Inhale, tuck your toes. And exhale, step back to your downward dog. Inhale, step your left foot forward. Lower your right knee down. Untuck your toes. Relax your hips. Relax your chest on top of your front thigh. Good. Just settling in. Surrendering to gravity. Let your hips release towards the floor. You can stay here, start to walk up to your thigh, opening your chest, maybe hands to prayer. Good. While you're here, start to engage through your pelvic floor and your low belly and your inner thighs reaching towards each other. Then maybe tuck your back toes and float the knee up. Maybe reach the arms up. Super engaged, super strong. Maybe look up to your hands. One more inhale. And exhale slowly with control. Lower your hands and knee back down. Beautiful. Untuck your toes. Shift your hips back. Flex your left foot, reaching your toes back towards your nose. And take your version of this half split. Maybe walk your hands further back to come up higher. Maybe take your hands to blocks. To go deeper, walk your hands out further away from your front foot. Super. Everyone looks beautiful. Take one more inhale here. Exhale back to your low lunge. Inhale, tuck your back toes. Exhale, step back, downward dog. Just start to notice your legs are awakening or opening a little bit more now. Stay for one more breath. Inhale, rise to your toes, look forward, walk your feet all the way up towards your hands. Keep a soft bend in your knees, feet just hip width apart. So inhale to rise up to our fingertips, just lengthen your spine. And exhale, pull your belly in to fold all the way down over your legs. You can keep your knees bent. Just shake your head, yes and no. You can have as big of a bend in your knees as you want or need today. Just relax your upper body. So that might mean a really big bend in your knees to just rest your chest on your thighs. Just hang, you can ragdoll, swing side to side. Maybe take opposite elbows. All right. I want you to let go of any idea of what's right and wrong or what any pose should look like. So just coming into our own bodies. Everyone looks different. Everyone is beautiful. So just take whatever beautiful variation of any pose you see today without any judgment. Let's come back to neutral, release your hands. Inhale, lift halfway up. Exhale, fold down, start to straighten your legs. Heel toe your feet together. Soften your knees again. Roll all the way up, vertebrae by vertebrae. Bringing your head up last. Release your arms down by your sides. You can close your eyes. Just feeling reconnected inwards to our bodies, our minds, and our breath. Feeling grounded into the earth underneath our feet. Engaging through our pelvic floor, low belly. Relaxing your heart space. And again, you can take a moment here to take your hands to prayer. And remember your intention. In the beginning of our practice. Gently blink your eyes open. We'll begin our sun salutations. Inhale, reach your arms up overhead. Exhale, fold all the way down to the floor. Again, your knees can be soft if needed. Inhale to lift halfway. Exhale, step back to a high plank position. Inhale here. Exhale, we take chaturanga. We bend our elbows to a low push-up. You can lower all the way down if you need to, all the way down. Inhale, coming through a cobra. Or an upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Stay in this downward dog. Bring your awareness back to your breath. Make sure your feet are hips distance apart. Just breathe. One more exhale. Inhale, rise to your toes, look forward, walk or jump your feet to your hands. Lift halfway up. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, rise all the way back up. Press your palms together, look to your thumbs. And exhale, fold straight back down over your legs, hands to the floor. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, step back, high plank. Make sure your index finger and thumb are pressing firmly into the mat. Exhale, chaturanga, bend your elbows or lower your knees and your chest, maybe everything all the way down. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward dog. Deep breaths in through your nose. Out through your nose. Finding stillness. Inhale, rise to your toes. Walk or jump your feet to your hands. Lift halfway. Exhale, fold all the way back down. Inhale, root to rise all the way up. Press your palms, look up to your thumb. And one more time, swan dive straight back down over your legs. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, step back to your plank. Shoulders over your wrists, inhale. Exhale, chaturanga, or modify. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward dog. Deep breaths. See if you can start to shift a little bit more weight towards your heels. Taking weight out of your arms. Maybe the heels will start to reach a little bit more towards the floor. One more breath. Inhale, rise to your toes, look forward, walk or jump your feet to your hands, and lift halfway up. Exhale, fold all the way down. Inhale, rise up, palms press, look up. Exhale, Tadasana, arms come down by your sides, strong like a mountain. Inhale, Utkatasana, chair pose. Sink your hips to your heels, press your palms, look to your thumbs. Hold it strong, squeeze your thighs. Exhale, fold straight back down, straight legs. Tuck your chin to your chest. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, step or jump back straight away to your version of chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Inhale, we come to warrior one. Step the right foot between your hands. Lower the back heel down. Deep bend in the right knee. Rise up. Warrior one. Arms up, maybe palms press. Hold it strong, deep bend in your knee. Knee right over your ankle, hips square over your right leg. And exhale, Vinyasa, lower your hands down. Step back through your chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, left foot steps between your hands, right heel down, warrior one on the left, Virabhadrasana A. Reach your arms up, square your hips, knee over your ankle. Inner thighs reach towards each other. One more inhale. Exhale, flow, hands down, step back, low push up. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Stay here for a moment in your downward dog. Just reset. If at any time you need to come back to child's pose that we took in the beginning of practice, you're always welcome. One more breath here. Let it all out through your nose. Inhale, step your right foot forward. Lower your back heel down. Come back to your warrior one. Arms reach, palms press. Exhale, let's interlace our fingers behind your back. Roll your shoulders back, lift your chest. Exhale, humble warrior. Right shoulder to the inside of your right knee. It doesn't matter how low you go. Starting to flow. Inhale, we pass all the way back up. And exhale, settle into a warrior two. Spread your wings. Stretch out long through your arms, reaching out long through your fingertips. Keep your knee directly over your right ankle, gazing directly over your right fingertips. Strong like a warrior. Inhale, flip your right hand up to face the ceiling. Reach back, reverse your warrior. Exhale, take your right forearm to your right thigh. Reach your left arm over your ear for an extended side angle. And stay here or lower your right hand down to the outside of your right foot or to a block. Try to keep your rib cage closed, shoulders back over your hips. Strong. Pelvic floor engaged. Exhale, lower your left hand down. Reach the right arm up. So just reversing the twist. We're coming to a twisted, extended side angle. Open. You can stay here, maybe lower your knee down. Maybe you want to bend the back knee, reach around, take your foot in your hand. Good. Keep sinking your hips forward and down like we did in our warm-up. Releasing into it, maybe your hands come to a block. Maybe it's a little better for you. And we'll release that bind. Start to take both hands to the inside of your right foot. Heel toe the right foot to the outer edge of your mat. And come to a lizard pose. So your back toes can stay tucked, or you can untuck them, take the top of your foot down. Maybe lower down to your forearms if it's available for you. If you have a bolster, that could also be helpful underneath your arms. Releasing into the hips. Maybe you want to roll onto the right pinky toe. Gently send the right thigh away, opening up through your chest. Good. Deep breath. Just settle in. And exhale, take your right hand back to the inside of your foot. Start to walk back up, heel toe. Your right foot to the center line. Lift your back knee and rise up to a high lunge. Open your heart. And exhale, Vinyasa, hands down. Step back through your chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Deep breath. And if you need a little break, take a child's pose. One more breath here. And inhale, other side, step the left foot between your hands, lower the right heel down, rise up through your Vajrasana A, warrior one. Interlace your fingers behind your back. Exhale there. Inhale, roll your shoulders back, open through your heart. Exhale, humble warrior, bowing forward. Left shoulder to the inside of your left knee. Starting to open through your shoulders. Find your pelvic floor. Inhale to rise up. And exhale, settle into warrior two. Spread your arms. Sinking low in the left leg. Your knee is directly over your ankle. Arms are reaching out from your shoulders. Looking over your left fingertip. Inhale, flip your left hand to the ceiling. Reach back, reverse your warrior. Big stretch across your whole left side. Staying low in the left leg. Exhale, extended side angle. Left forearm to left thigh, right arm sweeps over your ear. You can stay here or lower the left hand down to the floor to a block. Beautiful. Look up towards your right hand. Finding the alignment of your shoulders back over your hips. Exhale, take your right hand down to the inside of your right foot. Coming onto the right toes. Reach the left arm up, finding a twisted extended side angle. You can stay here and lower your right knee down. Maybe bend your knee, reach around, catch your foot. Remember, everything's just a suggestion. Just try and do what's best for you. And exhale, release that. Take both hands to the inside of your left foot. Heel toe the left foot to the outer edge of your mat. And exhale, lower down to your forearms if you can. Or just settle into your lizard on your hands if that's better for you today. Deep breaths here can be a really intense pose if our hips are feeling really tight. Even if your hips are feeling a little open, it still can be really intense, right? Gets that place. And maybe if you want to roll onto the left pinky toe and send the left thigh away gently with your left hand to open up a little deeper. One more inhale. Exhale, take your hands back to center. And start to heel toe the left foot to the center line of your mat. Inhale, tuck your back toes under, lift your knee up. We rise up to a high lunge, engage through your pelvic floor, open your heart, reach up to the ceiling. Exhale, Vinyasa, take your hands down, step back through Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing, deep breath. Inhale, right foot forward, find your warrior one again, rise all the way up. Exhale, interlace, move a little faster. Inhale, roll your shoulders back. Exhale, humble warrior. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, flip your hand, reach back, reverse your warrior. Exhale, now rise up with straight legs, heel toe the back foot in one time. Exhale, Trikonasana, triangle pose. Right hand reaches down somewhere along your right leg, left arm reaches up from your left shoulder. Shoulders back over your hips. Legs are straight. You can take your right hand to a block also. It's hard to straighten your legs. Walk the back foot in a little closer. And inhale, rise up with straight legs and turn all 10 toes to the left side of your mat. Exhale, hands to your waist. Inhale here. Exhale, take your hands to the floor in between your feet. Inhale, lengthen your spine, lift halfway up. Exhale, bend your elbows if you can, lower your head towards the floor. Maybe it touches, maybe it doesn't. Maybe you can walk your hands a little further back. Wherever you are, just shift your weight forward. Some of you, I think, can walk your feet a little bit closer together. If you feel like you're about to slide out to a straddle, we don't want that. Relax your neck, shift your weight towards the balls of your feet. Deep breath. Good. Inhale, lift halfway up. And exhale there. Inhale, rise all the way back up, hands to your waist. Turn the right toes back to the top of your mat. Reach your arms back out. Exhale, find your triangle pose again. Now this time, shift your gaze over your right foot. Take your block or your hand just slightly in front of the right foot and start to float the left leg up to a half moon. So if that feels really hard, you can just try or come back to your triangle. Maybe you could start to play with this pose, taking your right hand to the center of your heart, or bending your back knee and catching your foot. Anything you want to play with, any pose you like here. On your next exhale, we'll release both hands around the right foot. Come to a standing split. Relax your chin. Relax your chest down on your front thigh. And maybe you want to test your balance. One or both hands around your right ankle. See where your balance is today. Maybe you want to try handstand hops. Right. So whatever you're working on. Or maybe just work the flexibility, left leg reaching up towards the ceiling. One more breath here. Exhale, slowly lower down, coming to a lunge. Stretch the left leg back, bend your right knee. Inhale, rise back up to your high lunge. And exhale, vinyasa, hands down, step back through chaturanga, or just step back to your downward dog, if that was a lot. Exhale, we'll all meet in downward dog. Deep breath. If you need a child's pose, just take a few breaths there. And we'll all meet back in our downward dog. Looking good, everyone. Nice work. Inhale, step the left foot between your hands. Rise up, warrior one. Exhale, interlace your fingers. Inhale, roll your shoulders back, open your heart. Exhale, fold forward, humble warrior. Left shoulder to the inside of your left knee. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, warrior two. Stretch your arms, settle in, deep bend in your knee. Inhale, flip your left hand, reach back, reverse your warrior. Exhale, stand up, straight legs, arms out. Heel toe, right foot in one time. Exhale, reach down to Trikonasana, triangle pose. Good. Folding into your left hip crease. Right arm reaches up from your right shoulder. Shoulders back over your hips. breath, settle in. Keep the energy reaching up. Remember, the left hand can be on a block also. Whatever works best for you. Start to engage through your pelvic floor. Rise all the way up with straight legs. Spread your arms out from your shoulders. Turn all 10 toes to the right side of your mat. Exhale, interlace your fingers. Roll your shoulders back. Inhale, open your heart. And exhale, fold down. Tuck your chin towards your chest. Just start to reach your arms overhead. We don't need to pull, we don't need to force. Just breathe. Keep shifting more weight forward to the balls of your feet. One more breath here. Inhale, engage through pelvic floor to rise all the way up. Straight the legs. Good. Stretch your arms back out. Turn your left toes back to the top of your mat. Exhale back to Trikonasana, triangle pose. And then we'll play with our half moon. Shift your gaze over your left toes. Shift all your weight into your left leg. Walk your left hand out a few inches in front of the left foot, maybe to a block. And then you can float the right leg up. Your toes can be pointed or flexed. Try to keep your chest open to the right. Lay here. Maybe you can take your left hand to your heart. There. Maybe you can bend the right knee, reach around, catch your foot. Push your foot into your hand to open your hip more. Take both hands around the left foot. Being split, reach the right straight up to the ceiling. Good. And here, maybe testing your balance. Taking one or both hands around your ankle. Maybe testing your handstand hops. Is that something you're working on? Or just testing the flexibility, working through the flexibility, reaching your right leg straight up to the ceiling. One more inhale. Exhale, soften your left knee, reach the right leg all the way back behind you. And rise up to your high lunge. Exhale, vinyasa, hands down. Step back through your chaturanga or lower all the way down. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Deep breaths. Inhale, rise to your toes, look forward. Walk or jump your feet to the top of your mat and lift half. Exhale, fold all the way down. Soften your knees. Come back to your chair. Sink your hips to your heels. Press your palms together. Look up. Open your heart. Hold it here. Squeeze your thighs. Strong legs. One more breath. Sink your hips a little bit lower. And as we exhale, straighten your legs. Release your arms down by your sides. Coming back to our mountain pose. Tadasana. And then our mountain will become a tree. So we'll shift all of our weight to our left leg. You take your right foot to your left inner thigh, or you can keep it low. You can keep it just on your ankle. I'm just turning this way so you can see me. But you can stay facing the top of your mat. Engage through your pelvic floor. Take your hands to prayer. Finding balance. Strong like a tree. Good. You can stay here or maybe grow your branches, reach your arms up and out. You can maybe test your balance, maybe you can close your eyes, see what happens. Good. If you fall, it's good. That's how we learn. And exhale, take your hands back to prayer. And release your right leg down. Good. You can release your arms. We'll try the other side. So shift all of your weight to the right. And take your left foot either to your ankle, your calf, or your thigh. But just not on your knee. Engage through your pelvic floor, low belly in, palms press. Find your drishti, your steady focal point. And then maybe you can grow your branches. Arms reach up. Maybe you can again try, maybe close your eyes for a moment. See what happens. See if one side was better than the other. Just play, yeah. It falls, it's all good. Tells us things. And let's exhale, release your foot. Release your hands back down. Good. Inhale, let's flow down to the floor. Arms reach up. Exhale, hands down. Tuck your chin. Inhale, halfway. Exhale. Back for our last chaturanga of the day, I promise. Inhale, upward facing. And exhale, downward facing. Good. Lower your knees. Untuck your toes. Come to your child's pose. Take your hands back behind you, reaching for your toes. Just rounding over your legs. Bringing your awareness back inwards. Letting go of any of our thoughts about how the practice went. Coming back to our breath, back to our peaceful state of mind. Stay here for one more deep breath. Inhale, slowly roll all the way up, vertebrae by vertebrae, bringing your head up last. Shift your hips to one side, swing your legs around in front of you. Flex your feet. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, fold over your legs. Maybe catch your big toes with your peace fingers. Take your hands around your feet. Maybe interlace. However you want to do it, or just hands to your legs, wherever they can reach. Exhale, fold all the way down. Remember, there's no right or wrong way for the pose to look. If you're stretching something and you're not hurting yourself, and you're breathing, and your mind is calm, you're doing it right. Inhale to lift halfway up, just lengthen your spine. Exhale there. Inhale to come all the way back up. Bring the soles of your feet together. Open your knees to the side for Baddha Konasana. Your heels can be either far away from you, or you can take your heels closer in towards you. Take your hands to your feet. Inhale. Exhale, tuck your chin to your chest, round your spine, and take your forehead towards your toes. If your head is very far away from your feet, you can always place a block or two on top of your feet to bring your head down to rest on something. more full round of breath. And inhale, slowly roll all the way up, vertebrae by vertebrae. Bring your knees together, roll back to your sacrum. Point your toes, maybe bring your thighs closer in. And find Navasana, the boat pose, pick up your feet. Maybe extend your arms. Good, hold here for 5 breaths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Straighten your legs. Lift your chest. Hold for 1. Good, chest lift. 2. Try not to touch your legs. 3. Really good. 4, 5. Lower down to your back in 5 counts. Go 1, 2, nice and slow. 3. Good. 4, and 5. Exhale. Come all the way down to your back. Hug your knees into your chest. Rock gently side to side. A little massage for your low back. You can circle your knees if that feels good. And circle the other way. And stretch the left leg out long in front of you. Just hug the right knee in. And exhale, send the right knee over to the left. Maybe a nice easy twist. Extend the right arm out. Look over your right shoulder. Inhale, take your knee back up to your chest and straighten your leg. Hold on wherever you can reach. As you exhale, just gently guide your leg in closer to your chest. And exhale, release the right leg down to the floor. Hug the left knee in. Exhale, twist the left knee over to the right. Left arm reaches out from your left shoulder and turn your head to the left. Chest and straighten your left leg, hold on wherever you can reach. Exhale, gently guide the leg in towards your chest. One more inhale. And exhale, release the leg all the way down to the floor. Give your legs a shake. Hug your knees back to your chest one more time. Rocking gently side to side. You can open your knees, hold on to the outside of your feet, and come to a happy baby. Together. Give yourself a big hug. And as you exhale, release your arms and legs down to the floor. Let your legs be wide. Let your arms be wide. Close your eyes. yourself a few moments of rest. Where all the work we've done in our practice today comes together. Seeps into our bodies and our minds. We stay in the present moment. Trying not to think about what we need to do later, tomorrow. And take a moment, gently scan through your whole body, offering thanks and gratitude to each part of your body. Keeping our eyes closed, we can gently begin to reawaken. Wiggling our fingers and our toes, circling your wrists and ankles. And taking a final stretch, reaching your arms back overhead, long from your fingers to your toes. And slowly making your way over to a fetal position on either side. Stay there for a moment, taking a moment to think about how you want to arise and go about the rest of your day. What kind of person you want to be for the rest of the day. You can make that choice right now. In every moment, you can choose. Keeping your eyes closed, we'll gently begin to emerge, rising back up to a comfortable seated position. Bring your hands together at the center of your heart, recalling your intention from the beginning of our practice. Honor that intention. Honor yourself for showing up and practicing to be more peaceful, positive, healthier for yourself and the rest of the world. We hope that you'll hold on to these seeds of peace we planted this morning throughout the rest of your day and every day. Namaste.